Welcome to the lecture series of signals and systems. In the previous lecture, or we can say in last few lectures, we have seen almost all the aspects of the Fourier transform. We have seen the expression for the Fourier transform and inverse Fourier transform, which is called Fourier transform pairs. So we have seen all the properties, expressions involved in the transforming a signal from time domain to its frequency domain. And we have seen how important and powerful tool this is to convert a signal from its time domain to the continuous time signal from its time domain to its frequency domain. And we left with only a discussion of application of the Fourier transform in the analysis of the systems. So we will include this topic in the coming lectures. Now, what we have seen in the Fourier transform, this continuous time signal XT can be converted into in its equivalent frequency domain by using the Fourier transform. Similarly, if the given signal is in the discrete domain, then this discrete signal can also be converted in its frequency domain by using another tool similar to the Fourier transform, which is called discrete time Fourier transform. So in this lecture we will cover the discrete time Fourier transform in the same way as we learned the Fourier transform. First we will discuss the expressions involved in the transformation of the signal, then we will go through some examples, then we will include some important properties of the discrete time Fourier transform, and then we will include some more examples based on these properties, and then we will conclude the topic. So as the signal XT is converted into its frequency domain, similarly the signal XN can also be converted in the frequency domain by using this technique called discrete time Fourier transform. And the expression for discrete time Fourier transform can be given as, because this discrete time Fourier transform is an important tool in the analysis of the in digital signal processing, because this discrete time Fourier transform converts the complex convolution operations in the simple and easy multiplication of the signals. So it is more convenient to find the convolution by using the property of discrete time Fourier transform. So the expression for the determining the discrete time Fourier transform of a signal XN, it is given as Fourier transform of XN is equal to, it can be written X of omega or X of e power j omega, which is equal to sigma n is from minus infinite to plus infinite xn e power minus j omega n. Because we know the expression for the Fourier transform, it is integration from minus infinite to plus infinite xt e power minus j omega t dt. Because in this case the given signal is not continuous, it is discrete, xn is a discrete signal, so this integration will be converted into summation from minus infinite to plus infinite, and this term e power minus j omega t will be written as e power minus j omega n. And for the convergence of the discrete time Fourier transform, or we can say that for the existence of discrete time Fourier transform, there are Dirichlet conditions which says that we can find out the Fourier transform of the signal XN, means we can apply this expression to find the Fourier transform of the signal XN if the given signal XN is absolutely summable in the range from minus infinite to plus infinite. If XN is absolutely summable in the range from minus infinite to plus infinite. This is the condition, this is the sufficient condition to find the discrete time Fourier transform of the given signal xn. This is called Dirichlet condition. And to get this signal xn back from the given expression of x of omega, we will apply inverse discrete time Fourier transform, IDFT. IDTFT to find the xn back, because the frequency domain of the signal xn, x of omega, it is a periodic signal in the frequency domain. It means that if the signal is periodic with the period 2 pi, then to find the xn back, we have to integrate. This is periodic and a continuous signal also. So we have to integrate the signal from minus, for one period, either it is from minus pi to pi, or we can write it as from 0 to 2 pi, x, capital X of omega, e power plus j omega n d omega. This is the relation to find out the xn back from the given signal x of omega. So these two expressions, this is to transit from the time domain to frequency domain, and this expression will provide a transition from frequency domain to its time domain. Now we will include some standard signals and we will look what will be the discrete time Fourier transform of these signals. The first signal is delta t. So given signal xn here is, it is delta n. We have to find out the discrete time Fourier transform of this signal. So as per relation, we will write Fourier transform of xn will be equal to summation n is from minus infinite to plus infinite xn e power minus j omega n. Because the given signal is here, it is delta n, so I will write it as delta n e power minus j omega n, where n is from minus infinite to plus infinite. This function, it is well known function delta n, this will have value equal to 0 from minus infinite to plus infinite except at n equal to 0. It means that this signal will give value equal to 1 when n will be equal to 0. For the other values of n, this summation will be equal to 0. So this will be equal to e power minus j omega n when n is equal to 0. For the other values of n, this function will give value equal to 0, and this will be equal to e power 0, this is equal to 1. It means that the Fourier transform of the signal xn, which is equal to Fourier transform of delta n, is equal to 1. So I can write it as delta n is the Fourier transform pair. The discrete time Fourier transformation of delta n will be equal to 1. Now, if the signal is written in this way, suppose xn is given as delta n plus 3, if the signal is given as xn is equal to delta n plus 3 plus delta n minus 3, and we have to get the Fourier transform of this given signal xn. It means the impulse function delta n is shifted left by 3 plus delta n is shifted right by 3 unit. I have to get the Fourier transform of this signal. So we will apply the relation as Fourier transform of xn can be written as x of omega is equal to sigma n is from minus infinite to plus infinite xn e power minus j omega n. And in place of xn, I will write this function. So this will become sigma n is from minus infinite to plus infinite. This is delta n plus 3 plus delta n minus 3 e power into e power minus j omega n. I can break this summation as this is n is from minus infinite to plus infinite delta n plus 3 into e power minus j omega n plus n is from minus infinite to plus infinite delta n minus 3 e power minus j omega n. And we know again this is a delta function, impulse function. This function will be equal to 0 for all the values of n except at n equal to minus 3. So this will give some value at n equal to minus 3, and this function will give value equal to 1 at n equal to plus 3. So this can be written as this will be equal to e power minus j omega n when n is equal to minus 3 plus this will be equal to e power minus j omega n when n is equal to plus 3. So put these values of n and this will become e power plus j omega 3 plus e power minus j omega 3. And we know the relation of cos theta and exponential, complex exponential, as e power cos x can be written as e power j x plus e power minus j x by 2. So if you want to convert this signal into cos x, if you want to convert this signal into cos omega 3, then I have to divide in this by 2, and to compensate we have to multiply with 2, and this will become now x of omega will become 2 cos of 3 omega. This is how we can apply the concept of discrete time Fourier transform to get the frequency domain equivalent of a signal xn. Now consider another example where xn is given as a power n un. Xn is given as a power n u of n. Again, we will put in this case, because if a will be greater than 1, in that case this signal will become unbounded. Means if we check for the convergence of the Fourier transform, means xn should be less than infinite, means summation of xn from minus infinite to plus infinite should give a finite value which is not equal to infinite. So if I will put here a power n un, this limit will go from 0 to infinite because un is here. So this will become a power n, and this is a power 0 plus a power 1 plus a power 2 plus a power 3 and so on plus a power infinite. So obviously a power infinite is here. This series is not going to converge if the value of a is greater than 1. If value of a is greater than 1, then this will give value equal to infinite. So if the value of a is greater than 1, then this sequence xn will not be summable in the period from 0 to infinite, and that's why if a will be greater than 1, we cannot apply the expression of the discrete time Fourier transform to convert the signal from its time domain to frequency domain. It means that DTFT is not applicable for this given expression a power n un. But if it has a condition that a is less than 1. Now if a is less than 1 means value of a is between 0 and 1. Then in this case, this series is going to be converged and we can find out the Fourier transform of the given sequence. It means that we can find out the Fourier transform of the given signal a power n un if a is less than 1. So there is a condition on the a. I will apply the expression Fourier transform of xn will be equal to sigma n is from minus infinite to plus infinite xn e power minus j omega n. Put the value of xn, this summation will become from 0 to infinite, and in place of xn I will write a n e power minus j omega n. I can write it in this way also. This is sigma n is from 0 to infinite a e power minus j omega power n. I can write the expression in this way. This will become a power n into e power minus j omega n when we will multiply with n inside the power of the signal. So this series will become when I will put a e power minus j omega n, and in place of n I will write 0 plus a e power minus j omega n power 1 plus a e power minus j omega n power 2 plus, this will continue till the infinite. Then this will become 1 plus a e power minus j omega n will not be here, n is in the power, a e power minus j omega plus a square e power minus 2j omega plus so on. So from here we can see value of a is less than 1. This series is going to converge, and now we can apply the summation formula of the GP of infinite number of terms. So the summation, this can be written as a upon 1 minus r. A upon 1 minus r. Here r will be equal to a e power minus j omega, and a is equal to 1. So this will become x of omega will be equal to a upon 1 minus e power minus j omega minus j a omega. This will become value of r is a e power minus j omega. So this is the Fourier transform of the given signal A power n un with a condition that A is less than 1. So this is all for this lecture. In the next lecture, we will come with some more examples. After then, we will discuss the properties of the discrete time Fourier transform. Thank you.